There you are, Patrick. I've been trying to find you all evening.
It's 8 in the morning, SpongeBob.
Oh my gosh, 8 o'clock. I am late for work. Mr. Krabs is gonna kill me. Oh, Mr. Krabs.
Back at the Krusty Krab, King Neptune confronts Mr. Krabs about his alleged thievery. He asks if there is anyone present who may vouch for Mr. Krabs' character. And our yellow knucklehead McSpazitron shows up to accuse Mr. Krabs of being a horrible person. King Neptune zaps Mr. Krabs, causing SpongeBob to sober up quickly. He selflessly volunteers to journey to Shell City and retrieve the king's crown. Freezing Mr. Krabs in place, King Neptune grants a 6-day reprieve so SpongeBob and Patrick may attempt to retrieve the crown. King Neptune's daughter Mindy provides SpongeBob and Patrick with a magic mirror through which she can communicate and assist our heroic duo. We continue as SpongeBob and Patrick arrive at the Patty Wagon.
SpongeBob, Patrick, it's time to start your journey. Drive the paddy wagon through Bikini Bottom to the edge of town. This road will take you through Bikini Bottom to the edge of town. Don't let the paddy wagon take too much damage, or you'll have to start again.
Our journey begins. Epic, heroic, daring, valiant, courageous!
SpongeBob, you're driving a sandwich.
Not just a sandwich, a Krabby Patty.
With cheese.
Bye.
You've reached the edge of town, and now you can go on to the next part of your journey. Here's your reward. Come back again if you want another driving challenge.
With the chaos of Bikini Bottom behind us, SpongeBob and Patrick begin their long journey towards Shell City. However, with SpongeBob gone, all is not well. Plankton is now selling the Krabby Patty at the Chum Bucket, and with every purchase, customers are getting a mind-controlling bucket helmet. Squidward has discovered Plankton's plan to create an army of bucket heads. Will Squidward save the day? No. On the outskirts of town, SpongeBob and Patrick meet some of the charming locals who tell them they will not last long outside the city. But our friends do not listen. They should have listened. Our heroes are now stranded in a vast desert with only their feet for transportation.
Plankton is using those radio towers to broadcast his evil messages across the sea. SpongeBob, you have to find a way to shut those towers down. You have enough Goofy Goober tokens. Now I can teach you the bash move.
Now I am the master.
Wow! Thanks, Mindy!
Those radio towers are broadcasting Plankton's hypnotizing messages. If we don't do something soon, every creature in the sea will be under Plankton's control. You have to go into the desert and shut them down.
Isn't this the really dangerous desert that no one has ever returned from?
No. I think that's the desert next to this one.
Oh! Well, in that case, I'll have those towers shut down in a jiffy.
And I'll destroy all of you!
vacuuming up manliness, even in the corners. Whoa! It's a fragment!
Super spin cycle!
a man already.
Yeah.
I'm not feeling like a game of...
Victory!
I've found one last spot with those ugly Plankton propaganda towers. Use whatever you can find to knock them down. The last of Plankton's propaganda towers are here on the edge of the desert.
Oh, breathtakingly evil!
These tracks form part of a slide through this area. I need you two to race down them and knock those towers over.
Sounds kinda hard.
Don't worry, guys. Stay on the track, jump over obstacles, and hit any Plankton signs you see along the way. Good luck!